My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. Make sure that you hit that little bell next to the subscribe button too, in case you haven't already done so. That way you'll be notified every time I have a new video. The time has finally come for me to build my own spray booth. I've always had access to big walk-in spray booths, but I recently needed to do a little bit of model building for a project, so I built one out of half-inch foam core. I was able to build the entire spray booth out of a 40 by 60 sheet using a filter from the local big box retailer and some plans from ventworks.com. I also used 146 CFM vent fan that I got from Menards. It runs at 33 decibels, so it's quite quiet, and I needed to modify the plans a little bit. The plans from VentWorks show a side venting exhaust fan, and I had an exhaust hole right above where my fan was going to be, so I used a different fan. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to lay out my plans. I'm going to draw them directly onto the foam core, and then I'm going to cut them out. I'm using a standard X-Acto blade to cut out all the pieces and quite a long ruler. The scale's a little bit different than sort of building desktop models, but it's really not that big of a deal. Now, one of the other big differences between my spray booth and the plans that I started with is that I'm making my a side loader, meaning my exhaust filter is able to come out the side and be replaced. In the plans, they show like a kind of a top loader. This makes it super easy to replace the filter at any time. Also used a 14 by 25 filter, which is a different size than what they show in the plans, but it's easy to modify all that stuff. So just like in all the other foam core videos that I make, we're going to bevel all the edges and glue everything together. That's going to give us a really nice edge with no visible foam, and we're going to use the exact same technique. So if you haven't seen the other foam core building videos, go back and watch those. We're using the same techniques to assemble this, even though the scale is different. Doesn't matter, same thing. All right, things are starting to come together here. I use a square to make sure everything is true, and we got two sides put together. I used some weights to hold it. Now we're going to attach the back panel. The piece is going to start to have some strength at this point. Again, beveling everything, gluing it, just like I would build any other model. And I'm using tape to hold everything together. I'll let that dry, and this piece becomes very strong. Like I always say, white glue gives me great strength. Now I'm attaching like a little filter stop guide over there on the left. I slide the filter through. Of course, there's going to be a vacuum behind the filter, and then that's going to be pulling the filter against that. I still add a little stop so that it can't fall forward. I add a little brace behind on the inside that you can't see. Let's take a look at the fan. Here it is arriving. I'm unboxing it, and of course I have to immediately dismantle it and see how it's put together. I take it apart because I only need part of it. It's a dual stage fan or dual speed fan, and it works fantastic. This is the top panel where the fan's going to get installed. So at this point, when I was building it, I still had planned to use a flexible or a adjustable 90 degree elbow attached to the fan. You can see that on the top of the fan. Here I'm cutting out the circle for where the fan is going to go. I end up ditching that 90 degree elbow and use just a flexible piece of hosing. To sand out the inside of the circle, I use my oscillating spindle sander, and then I'm going to bevel the bottom inside edge just to have a little bit better airflow. I'm going to use some E6000 to glue the fan onto the foam core. I'm going to add some gussets onto the big panel that hold the fan in place, and here I'm sanding a little bit of a curve into those gussets. You'll notice there's a little piece of material in the middle of the foam core there, and I actually bend and pre-stress that entire top panel to get some additional strength because I'm worried about the weight of the fan and the foam core. Next, I'm adding in the little divider piece that finish holds the filter in place, and I glue that down. A great thing to have for your spray booth are some lights, and I use some leftover LED strip lights that I have from a previous project, and I glue them down with some E6000 as well. I also attach a switch and a little power connector so that I can switch the LEDs on and off. It's a 12 volt system, and I want to be able to turn the lights on and off. Here's the unit all put together and kind of spin it around. I'm going to remove the tape and we're pretty much done. Next thing, install. You can see the flexible hose that comes into my shop there that I connect to the unit. Super easy to do that. Turn on the light. Very nice and easy and simple. The only thing left to do is to tape the exposed edges, just like when we were building a model. Do the same thing on here so we got a nice finish. If you build something like this, leave a comment below. Let me know how it goes. If you have any improvements or anything, leave it in the comments below and let people know. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line.